In this video, I will show how to build this small outboard motor, which has everything in it in order to make a remote control board. With the trick of the direct drive, you can save a lot of space for all the components here, so the entire RC boat will fit in a small motor like this one. You can apply the motor on any boat almost, like a Playmobil boat or a wooden boat. And you will not have any more issues with the coupling, flex shaft and gears. The motor is water-cooled and so you can pump a lot of power on it. This method is much more convenient than my previous build, which has a rear axle of a RC car in order to make the 90 degrees angle.
Let's start. All you need for the conversion is MG90 servo, receiver, bidirectional speed controller, 1306 brushless motor,
propeller
and 3D printed part. I will provide the 3D printed part file on Thingiverse.
Let's start with the preparation of the material.
Sandpaper on the 3D printed files and remove all the spurious parts. We need to remove the servo cable and shorten it, otherwise it will not fit inside the small motor hood. Then we will have to waterproof the servo.
Waterproof also the ESC. The motor may fall into the water. Remove the rear clip of the motor so that you can disassemble it without effort.
Cut some dent on the screws in order to have more grip when you are fixing the motor.
Glue the nuts in the 3D printed parts. Solder the motor wires to the speed controller. Channel 2 on the throttle, channel 1 on the servo. Enlarge the propeller hole to a 5mm.
To waterproof the motor, I used clear paint on the stator and I will spray corrosion X on the bearings.
I actually found corrosion X only not sufficient, so please push a lot of nautical grease directly inside the bearing and then close the cap. This will last for many rounds.
And now we are ready to run. I started with this wooden boat, which was built by my grandpa. I used the motor for several months now. If you put a lot of grease on the bearings and corrosion X everywhere, you will not have any rust. I tested on rivers, lakes, swimming pool, fountains, and a couple of times in salt water.
And this is how the motor looks after 6 months and I guess 50 runs at least. You see, we have no rust or very small rust, and the grease is padded on the bearing, but the bearing is safe. I reinforced this part because this was breaking, and I placed an anti-ventilation plate. The motor is still running smooth.
Honestly, I wanted to draw something like this, but I'm not good on mechanical drawing, so if you're willing to help, please post a new skeleton for this motor.
Goodbye and thanks for watching.